Known as the man that completed 7 voyages, embarked on countless adventures, and most recently took on the Furies.
Jim, that's Furies, and also the wrong Sinbad.
Oh, these writers think they're so funny. Well, I guess we'll just come from a different world, and I'll have to keep on cruising to avoid any necessary roughness. All right. If you haven't guessed by now, we're really here for comedian and actor David Adkins, or as you may better know him, Sinbad. A master of all mediums since the early 80s, let's take a look at what everybody's favorite mononymous Michiganian has been up to in this installment of Where Are They Now? Early in his life, the young talent was a member of the United States Air Force, working as a boom operator on KC-135 stratotankers. His military career wasn't to be, however, as he was eventually discharged dishonorably, allegedly for going AWOL and, as he puts it, parking his car in the wrong position. Had he stayed in the Air Force, chances are he may never have landed his first starring role as Byron Lightfoot in The Red Fox Show, which came shortly after his appearance on Star Search in 1985. Donning the name Sinbad, chosen to pay tribute to the Middle Eastern sailor, the actor-comedian took his humor to all sorts of outlets for a lengthy and eclectic career of movies, stand-up specials, and television shows. Sinbad's earlier years focused heavily on television as he enjoyed a 57-episode run on A Different World, starred in the lead role of David Bryan on The Sinbad Show, appeared on The Cosby Show, Cosby, and All That, and received the great honor of hosting Saturday Night Live in 1992. Amid his budding fame, Sinbad kept his comedy act alive through a series of specials, including the HBO Comedy Showcase in 1995, and participation in events like the 10th Annual Montreal Comedy Festival and the 7th Annual American Comedy Awards. In 1995, he starred in Houseguest, and a year later was back on the silver screen working alongside Arnold Schwarzenegger in Jingle All the Way. Back on the small screen, from October of 1997 to summer of 1998, Sinbad took over as host of Vibe's syndicated talk show. Go through the history of Sinbad's career and you'll be hard-pressed to find a period of downtime. Even during phases where his presence in film and television was non-existent, the comedian still had his stand-up and gig hosting to fall back on, though his schedule seemed to be pretty packed. In 2009, the funny man made headlines for filing Chapter 7 bankruptcy and revealing a multi-million dollar tax bill. 4 years later, TMZ spotlighted the comedian again when he filed for bankruptcy a second time, citing debts amounting to $374,979 to American Express and $2.3 million to the California Franchise Tax Board.
I spent money. I kept thinking, okay, I'll get one more movie and I'll wipe these bills out, but that movie didn't come.
Not to get caught up in the negativity, Sinbad kept working and, after his 2013 bankruptcy, appeared in Comedy Bang Bang, Steven Universe, The Scout, American Dad, and Comics Unleashed. Though he's not slated for any known theatrical productions as of early 2017, Sinbad is still in the comedian circuit, performing recently at the McCurdy's Comedy Theater and L. Douglas Wilder Performing Arts Center, with future dates at Nyack Levity Live Comedy Club. For April Fool's Day in 2017, Sinbad showed he still had his comedy prowess by working off the internet's insistence that he starred in a 90s genie movie called The collaboration with College Humor was a clever nod to 90s writing and film style and the gullibility of the web. For those of you wanting to follow David on a daily basis, check him out on Twitter at SinbadBad and his touring schedule at www.bandsintown.com/Sinbad.